Please see the link in the description to download a worksheet for this video. Experiments can be dangerous. If you are a child, never do experiments unless your parent, guardian, or adult educator says it's all right and is there with you the whole time. What do you think of if someone says water? Most of us think about a glass of water or a beautiful sight in nature. Few of us think about ice cubes, glaciers, or icebergs. But ice is a form of water. Likewise, few of us think of steam from a kettle or steam at a geyser. But steam is a form of water. In science, instead of saying forms of water, we say states of water. Ice is the solid state of water. This is the liquid state of water, and steam is the gas state of water. Like water, other things, such as this butter, can be in the solid state, liquid state, or gas state. Instead of saying the word things, scientists use the word matter. Matter is in its liquid state when it will take on the shape of the container it is in. When we talk about the gas state, we're talking about vapors. The common word for water's gas state is steam. We might be able to see gas for a little while, but it usually disappears quickly, so it's hard to see. Whenever we are smelling something, whether it's coffee or food, some of those vapors went into our noses. The word gas in gas state has nothing to do with the abbreviation for gasoline. When matter is in the gas state, we can easily squeeze it into a smaller space, unlike when it is in a solid and a liquid state, in which it is hard to squeeze. Which of these would you say are in the solid state? This flexible foam earplug? This hollow cone or its hollow cup? This solid cube of copper? All of these are in the solid state. Although we commonly use the word solid to mean something that is rigid and not hollow, in science, we use the phrase solid state to mean something that can hold its shape rather than taking on the shape of the container it is in. Since all of these objects are holding their shape without a container, they are in the solid state. Water freezes when its temperature goes below 0 degrees Celsius. The temperature at which matter goes from a liquid state to a solid state is called its freezing point. Water melts when its temperature goes above 0 degrees Celsius. The temperature at which matter goes from a solid state to a liquid state is called its melting point. For almost all matter, its freezing point and melting point are the same number. For example, the freezing and melting point for these glue sticks is 115 degrees Celsius. So the glue changes from a solid state to a liquid state when the nozzle on this device is hotter than 115 degrees. Then the glue freezes back into a solid state when its temperature cools below 115 Celsius. Since the freezing and melting points for a specific matter are usually the same temperature, most reference tables only list the melting point. But you can think of the melting point's temperature as the value for both the melting and freezing points for that matter. When we heat water's temperature above 100 degrees Celsius, it changes from a liquid state to a gas state. The temperature at which matter goes from a liquid state to a gas state is called its boiling point. If we cool that gas, such as by directing it at a cold object, then the gas turns back into a liquid and drips off the object. The temperature at which matter goes from a gas state to a liquid state is called its condensation point. Usually, the boiling point and condensation point are the same for a type of matter. Here is water in its three states. We can make a diagram of these states by drawing a vertical number line to represent temperatures. As with all number lines, the smaller numbers like 50 are close to zero, and the bigger numbers like 100 are farther from zero. The negative numbers are below zero. Next, we make marks where the boiling point and freezing points are. The state between these two marks is the liquid state. The state below the freezing point is the solid state. And the state above the boiling point is the gas state. Here is butter in two states, and we are given the value of its boiling point and freezing point. To diagram its states, we again draw a vertical number line to represent its temperatures, making sure that the smaller numbers are close to the number zero, and the larger numbers are farther from zero. All the negative signs are below the number zero. Then, we make marks where the boiling point and freezing points are. The state between those marks is the liquid state. The state below the freezing point is the solid state. And the state above the boiling point is the gas state. Here's the last example on diagramming a state of matter, this time using coconut oil. We're given values for its boiling point and freezing point. We make a vertical number line At the boiling and freezing points, draw a box to show where the liquid state is, draw a box to show where the solid state is, and draw a box to show where the gas state is. Knowing how to diagram the states of matter can be a useful way to visualize the states of matter when we are asked to compare different examples of matter, as we'll show next. We poured water into the cup on the left, and we poured isopropyl alcohol, commonly known as rubbing alcohol, into the cup on the right. Both look the same, but isopropyl alcohol would be very dangerous to drink. This reminds us that many clear fluids look like water, but can be dangerous. Then we put both cups in the freezer, and when we remove them, we find that the isopropyl alcohol is still in the liquid state, but the water has changed from its liquid to its solid state. Is isopropyl alcohol's freezing point higher or lower than water's freezing point? Since the isopropyl alcohol is still a liquid, even when its temperature is below 0 degrees Celsius, its freezing point is lower than water's freezing point of 0 degrees Celsius. Here is the diagram of both matters with their values written in. The freezing point for isopropyl alcohol is much lower than the freezing point of water, so it will only change to a solid state when its temperature reaches negative 89 degrees Celsius. Alcohols are a type of chemical that have low freezing points. One example is the isopropyl alcohol we just demonstrated, and another example is a chemical in antifreeze which we put in car radiators. The reason we want a chemical with a low freezing point in our car radiators is so that even on very cold days when water everywhere in nature is frozen, our radiators will not be destroyed by having their radiator fluid turn into solid ice. All of this water is changing from its liquid state to its gas state, since this kettle's temperature is above water's boiling point. That change happens so fast that we can see the gas bubbles forming inside the liquid water. But matter can also change from its liquid state to its gas state at a much slower speed during a process called evaporation. In everyday use, we commonly say air drying instead of the word evaporation, but they mean the same thing. You may have experienced evaporation after you go for a swim in a pool, a lake, or an ocean on a hot day, and then dry off without a towel. The sand on this beach is going from wet to dry as the tide falls, because the water in the sand is evaporating. If you have ever seen a little tea left in a cup in the evening, you may have noticed that the next morning the tea is gone. That's because it evaporated. That means the tea went from a liquid state to a gas state slowly, and at a temperature far cooler than its boiling point. Evaporation is the same reason that wet clothes dry on a clothesline. With time, the water in the clothes changes from a liquid state to a gas state, even though the water in those clothes never reaches water's boiling point of 100 degrees Celsius. Since matter can go from a liquid state to a gas state in two ways, by boiling or by evaporation, scientists use a general term called vaporization to summarize the process of going from a liquid state to a gas state using either method. Condensation is when matter goes from its gas state to its liquid state. You may have noticed condensation on a bathroom mirror if you run hot water in the sink. That happens because the water vapor in the air is condensing on the cold mirror. The air gets colder as it gets higher above the ground. So when water vapor in the air is about 5 miles above the ground, it gets so cold that it condenses from its gas state into its liquid state. We see that liquid state as tiny water droplets in the form of clouds. This is a common diagram to show the names for changing states. Sometimes we call these phase transitions instead of state changes. States of matter and state changes play a big role in technology and engineering, in a similar way to how people use a glue stick with a hot glue device. A welder melts a stick of metal with a welding arc whose temperature can be over 2,000 degrees Celsius. When that metal cools below its melting point, it changes from its liquid state back to its solid state, and has then made a bond between the two pieces of metal. When we need to make a lot of metal objects, such as these dumbbells, we use a process called casting. This works in a way similar to how we make ice cubes with an ice cube tray. First, the metal is heated above its melting point, so it melts from a solid state to a liquid state. Then that liquid metal is poured into a mold during which it will take on the shape of its container. Once the metal cools below its melting point, it changes from its liquid state into its solid state. To illustrate casting in greater detail, we'll use this gallium metal, which has a melting point of 30 degrees Celsius. It is melting in this man's hand because our body temperature is 37 degrees Celsius. Once the metal is in its liquid state, we pour it into this mold, then let it cool down below its melting point. So it changes from its liquid state to its solid state. We've made a tiny metal cast in the shape of an apple. Here's a summary of the topic we just covered. Please pause the video to read this if you wish. If you're interested in practice tests that are similar to state exams, but with detailed, colorful explanations for each answer, then please see our apps in the App Store. Many of these are free and none expire or limit their function. Since we only make educational products for children, none of our apps have third-party advertising, in-app purchasing, or connect to the internet. Please subscribe if you'd like to be notified of future educational videos we make. Thanks for your attention.